Hello, I'm Enrique Rueda-Sabater, and I want to tell you about the internet economy. I hope it sounds intriguing enough, and I hope you will read the Global IT Report chapter where we have written about this topic. Why have we written about the internet economy? Think about the world of the internet. We believe that it surrounds us. We believe that it's pervasive, that everybody is immersed in it. And yet, out of 7 billion people almost in the world today, only 2 billion people have experienced the internet already. There is a lot to come. There is a lot potential benefits from the internet yet to be realized. These benefits are personal, they are social, they are economic, they affect the productivity of enterprises, the efficiency of governments. So it's quite interesting to find a measure to track the evolution of this world of the internet in economic terms. Put it simply, the internet economy is the purchasing power in the hands of internet users. It combines, therefore, two things: the results of economic growth and demographic factors that also are making a generation of people join the internet with a lot of enthusiasm for what it has to offer. The internet economy globally is today still dominated by advanced market countries. These countries account for about 70% of the internet economy, and therefore emerging countries account for only 30%. But we see that changing very fast. Only 10 years ago, emerging countries had less than 10% of the global internet economy. In 10 years' time, we see them accounting for at least half of the global internet economy. And this, in part, is also reflecting a phenomenon that we also discuss in the chapter that we call the global consumer class. This is the number of people with enough purchasing power to become consumers of information and communications technology, both services and devices. These individuals, again, used to be mostly in advanced markets. Increasingly, the growth of the global consumer class, people with per capita incomes above $6,000, is taking place in emerging countries. And their numbers are growing very, very rapidly, by hundreds of millions of people every few years. The combination of these two things is what makes the growth of the internet economy such an interesting phenomenon, and the moment that we live now, such a fascinating evolution to track. We see the future path of the internet, the direction in which it's going, as fairly clear. The internet of the future is going to be larger in every sense, and it's going to have a broader scope. It's going to generate lots of benefits. But how will we get there? The path will have lots of twists and turns. These are not terribly predictable. And therefore, to explore all of that uncertainty around the future of the internet and all the possibilities of the opportunities and the challenges, we have also developed a series of scenarios. Scenarios on the future of the internet in the year 2025. A lot can change between now and 2025, but also if we think about that future, we will have important insights in how we can prepare for that, how we can influence, how can even shape it. And these scenarios of the future of the internet are referred to in the chapter, but you can find the full report, which is very fun to read, I think. You can look for it in cisco.com. If you search for Internet 2025, you should be able to find it very easily. And I hope you will find that it helps you develop insights to make the most of the future of the internet and its tremendous potential, and also to deal with the challenges that it may throw at you.